What's up? How y'all doing? So today's gonna be like a pretty short story time. Like I've been slacking a lot for, you know, I know you don't have to tell me. I know what you're thinking. Like, bitch, where have you been? I know. It's been 3 months and definitely let me catch you up with all the craziness that's been going on in my life so that y'all understand, like, I didn't abandon y'all. I've been like going through shit. Like life has just been crazy, y'all. Like just been crazy. So let's just jump into it before I start blabbering. Boom. So first I want to say why I stopped working in the nightlife. So I was working in nightlife. I started in July of 2017, if I'm not mistaken. And I mean, at the time it was working really good for me. I liked the hours because I'm in school, I'm a full-time college student, so my class time usually ranged from like 8 a.m. to maybe like 2 p.m. usually. Yeah, sometimes I take night classes, but not often. It's only one day a week, so it's not really that big of an effect on my schedule. So my classes usually range from about 8 to 2 o'clock or 9 to 3, you know, around that time frame. So for me to go to work, for me to have to just start getting ready for work about like 9 o'clock and be to work by 11 and then know that I'm getting off and should be home by 7 a.m, that worked perfectly for me. Even though that didn't leave me much time for going to sleep, I could take a nap like after class, but for the most part, I worked for my hours because it didn't, like, my job didn't affect my school time. Like I could focus on school during the day and I can get my money at night, and I was only working about 2 to 3 days a week anyway. So, and what I was working at 2 to 3 days a week, I was making what I would make in fucking, let's see, shit, like probably 3 paychecks working a regular minimum wage job. So the fact that I can make that in like 2 days out of the week instead of having to bust my ass 7 days a week just to make that same, like not even a third of that, was great. So I really like the money. But mostly I had to stop because it was a lot of long nights and early mornings. And like I said, it works for a while, but when you have like days on days on days where you're getting like 3 to 4 hours of sleep, if that, for me, that's not gonna work. I have to sleep, okay? Like, I'm just wanting, you know how everybody just has that one thing they need? Like, some people need food, some people need prayer, some people need shit, water, I don't know. I need fucking sleep, okay? I've never liked my sleep being interrupted since I was a baby. Since I came out the womb, I've never played about my sleep. So sleep is not something I can just neglect and put off because it's other things that's more important. I have to make sure I get at least 7 hours of sleep to be a functioning, nice person, okay? Because if I don't sleep, I'm a bitch. I'm not gonna lie. I'm a fucking bitch, to be honest. I'm a bitch. I can't focus. I can't function. I don't want to talk. Like, I'm just a fucking zombie. I hate everybody. So I need my sleep. And all those long nights and early mornings just really started to get to me after a while. So that was one of the main reasons that I stopped having to work in the nightlife. Like, and then it started to change my psychological perspective. Like, both on like a lot of things. Like, for one, it changed my perspective on men. It just like made me look at men in a different way. Like, you guys are really disgusting pigs. I'm not saying all men are, but it made me start feeling like that because the men that I was exposed to in my like daily environment just seemed like pigs to me. Then it started to change my perspective on myself. Like, the longer I started working in a club, the more I noticed that I wanted to like change things about myself. Like, I was like, oh, you know, I want my weave to be longer because longer weaves looks more sexy or it looks more attractive. And, you know, I want my waist to be slimmer because slim waists and big booties and big boobs look better. And that's what's in right now. So it's just like, I kind of like, I'm not bragging, but I came into the club with a really nice body. Like, I've always kind of had like a really nice shape. I just, genetics blessed me, thank God. And I was really athletic growing up, so I kept my body like really, really toned. So I came in with a really nice shape. I didn't have much of a stomach at all. I pretty much had like a slim waist and a flat stomach. But I kind of got outrageous when I started working at a club. When I was like exposed to people who got work done to their body, I'm like, yeah, I want to get my boobs done. Like, yeah, I want to get my butt done. I want to get my waist done. And it was just like, that wasn't me before I started working in clubs. So it was just like, I knew that me working in that environment was starting to affect the way that I felt about myself and my self-esteem and like what made me feel beautiful. When I know, before I even walked into the club, I knew I was, even if I wasn't the baddest thing in that club, my confidence said that I was. Like, that you couldn't tell me that I wasn't the baddest thing in this club. Like, that's how my confidence when I walked in. And when I was like on my way out, it just changed. Like, I just started feeling like I wasn't the baddest thing in this club. Like, I was probably one of the worst looking girls. I didn't get as much attention. Like, am I still attractive? I felt like I was getting fat all the time. Like, it was ridiculous. So I just had to take a step back because I was like, you know, this is not me and I don't want to have this type of feeling. Like, I worked so fucking hard and so long to work on my self-esteem to get it to where it needed to be for something like this environment just to strip it away from me that easily. So I was just like, no, I can't do this. No, I can't. And it's just like, towards the end, it wasn't keeping me as fulfilled as it was before. Like, I don't know, like, when I first started, it was like the greatest job ever. I was like, yo, I'm doing this, not for the rest of my life, of course. I never planned on doing it for a long period of time, but I did, you know, I was like, this is great. I'm never gonna stop this. Like, as long as I have the means to do this and whatever the qualifications, I'm gonna stick to this lifestyle because it's great. Like, I love it. Like, what would you not love about it? Like, it's great money. You know, all I have to do is stand here, be cute. All I have to do is get cute every day, do my makeup, do my hair. That was shit I like to do anyway. So like, the fact that I'm pretty much getting paid to look fine was just like, yo, this is the greatest job ever. I'm never leaving this place. Like, yeah, but it just wasn't keeping me as fulfilled towards the end. And I don't know, like, I just wasn't really happy there anymore. And I knew I was looking for something more and I wanted more out of life at that point. So eventually I just stopped. And if you guys want to know the like thing that pushed me all the way over the edge and like the thing that was just like, yo, I'm fucking done, I can't do this no more, I'm over it, make sure you guys watch my next video. It's gonna be down in my description. I'm gonna put the link in my description, so make sure you guys click on that. And make sure you like this video. Make sure that you comment, give me some feedback, you know, good, bad, positive, whatever. You know, I would love if you guys make sure that you subscribe to my channel so you guys can stay caught up with all my videos. And yeah, bye friends.